Amazing. President Trump slams CFPB as a total disaster, vows to restructure it, it's epic. President Trump criticized the Consumer Financial Protection Bureau, CFPB, because it's devastating to the financial institutions of this country. The idea of a national board to protect consumers is a good one, but the problem in the Bureau lies in the way the Democrats jury-rigged the agency so that it was independent of Congress and the President. Secondly, after the beginning of the agency, being a conservative guaranteed you would never work there. The CFPB was the brainchild of ultra-liberal Elizabeth Warren, who had hoped to named as the director, where she could play Queen Bee without anyone exerting control over her or the agency. She was gravely disappointed when Obama refused to nominate her for the position after she testified before Congress, leaving the Senate terribly unimpressed by her. Obama appointed failed Ohio politician Richard Cordray, who had been elected as Attorney General, only to be tossed out on his rear in the very next election when Ohio voters threw out the corrupt Democrats who won in a wave election just 4 years before. Ronald L. Rubin was hired by the CFPB early on, and he said that 2 months later he could not have been hired owing to the fact he was a Republican. Rubin wrote a column for the National Review exposing the CFPB. Right now, there is a battle shaping up over the CFPB. Corrupt Democrat Richard Cordray appointed Leandra English as deputy director, trying to allow himself to pick his successor even as President Trump announced that Mick Mulvaney, current director of the Office of Management and Budget, to run the agency until someone is nominated and confirmed by the Senate. Hiawatha Warren is saying that Cordray and not Trump has that authority even after a federal court ruled that the way the Democrats set up the agency is totally unconstitutional. The court fixed the problem by ruling that the president has the right to remove the director at the CFPB at will. From the National Review. Circumventing the Constitution took 2 steps. First, Democrats inserted a few clever workarounds into the Dodd-Frank Act, which created the CFPB on July 21, 2010. Commissions such as the one Warren first proposed are ostensibly bipartisan, so a president-appointed director would lead the new agency. Since there might be a Republican president one day, the director would be practically irremovable after Senate confirmation to a 5-year term that could extend indefinitely until the next director's confirmation. To prevent future Republican-led Congresses from cutting the Bureau's budget, funding would be guaranteed through Federal Reserve profits rather than taxpayer dollars. Next, the enlarged new agency would be staffed with Democrats, top to bottom. There would not be a Republican director nominee for at least 5 years, and if one was ever confirmed, entrenched left-wing managers could undermine attempts to weaken consumer protection. The plan wasn't perfect, but it was pretty good. Corralling the CFPB is just another move by this president to destroy the liberal corruption that permeates every corridor of power in the executive branch. Just one more step in draining the swamp.